Hey, this is Spike from DRI, and you're watching Rob 2. Yeah.
Thank you, guys.
Don't turn that channel.
Remember I said I'm going to do 566 right off the bat. Now, you guys may not know this, but I'm not even dressed for the occasion. So, it was her double. Her double. Nah, I'm just fucking around. Her fucking double, dude. Here, I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys like a shot of her. That was the front of it, and this was the back. Now, of this, now these are pretty fucking exclusive. This was exclusive because for one, you couldn't get it anywhere else but there. Now, if anybody can see what the background is, you'll know where there is. Okay, and I was there. Now, I didn't personally get this from her there, but some dude was carrying it around and it was fucking raining. And I was like, hey man, because it was all getting wet. And I can see on the look of his fucking face that he's just sick of fucking this piece of paper that he's having to protect. And fucking Indy 500 qualifying guy. Yeah. So I'm going to zoom that in like myself. So he gave it to me. I was like, oh my god! Mint coin collection. Now this was what I saw the other day. It was shit. Now I'm gonna go ahead and take this out of the box because I can. Here's a little box. But it says considered a pioneer for women in motorsports. Danica Patrick is the most successful woman in the history of America open wheel racing. She holds the record for the highest finish by a female in the Indy 500, third in 2009. In 2005, Danica became the first female driver to lead the Indianapolis 500 when she led 19 laps as a rookie. She is the only woman to win an IndyCar series race with her victory in the 2008 Indy Japan 300. In 2005, Danica was named Indianapolis 500 and IndyCar series rookie of the year and was the series most popular driver from 2005 to 2006, or 2010 I mean. The 102nd running of the Indianapolis 500 will make the final race of Danica's racing career. So, this was actually from over there. And there's the back of what I just read for you guys. And I just showed you that. Now, this was the actual paper. So, this is from Saturday, May 19th, 2018. They were selling it. The guy was... this is the Indianapolis Star. So, $2. I had to fucking pay $2. I waited early in the morning at the store. No dice, didn't get it. They didn't get it early. It took a long time for them to get it. You can't really see that. Here's a close up, or here's a good shot of her. That's an old picture. Yep, they didn't get it. And I forgot all about it, so I went down there for qualifying and shit. Now, went in. Finally, this dude's like, hey, I forgot about the paper completely because I'm already watching qualifying, so I completely forget about it. So this guy out of nowhere is selling these fucking papers. The paper, the Indianapolis fucking whatever. What is it? Fuck, I got it right here. The Indianapolis, the Indy Star, it says. The Indianapolis Star. Here's the front fucking page. Again. So anyway, so this guy is selling these fucking newspapers, $2. I'm like, oh, fuck. I didn't think about it at first, so when I went and bought one from him for $2, I'm like, ah, fuck it, I'll take one. $2, and I'm like, and then it's her on the fucking front page, of course, and I'm like, oh, hell no. I really didn't want to pay no more, so I just bought. I settled with the two. I was thinking about buying like $100 worth, but I was like, nah, never mind. didn't even have $100 worth anyways, or have $100. Danica brings Donna Kern down on a career with a crash. The last race of Danica's 14-year career behind wheel ended with a crash, leaving her devastated at the Indianapolis 500 on Sunday. She had a fast car that she qualified 7th that I saw. Of 33 last weekend that I was there. Along with high hopes and a real chance to better her career, high third place finish of 2009. So, now I'm not rubbing my eyes because I'm fucking crying, even though I am. It's been fun. I mean, it was really fucking kick ass following her around, you know what I'm saying? There was the one time I remember in Chicagoland, she was racing for Indies back then because it was a lot easier for her to get to her back when she raced with the Indies. Of course, she was just Indy cars. When she went with NASCAR for a couple years-ish or whatever, couldn't get to her as close as you can with the Indies. So she was at this mall. So I went down there, got to the, first it was a Boost Mobile store. And, too bad I couldn't get footage of that. Got pictures, but, so, I get the autograph from her, take pictures. Oh, the bouncer told me I had to stop taking pictures. He's like, I was taking too many pictures, too many flashes in her fucking face, because I was flashing with the flash. So she was probably like, you know what I mean, like, dude, already stop with the fucking flashes, motherfucker. I kept on fucking flashing, though. I kept on taking pictures. I didn't give a fuck. So he told me after a while to quit taking pictures. I must have got about maybe 18 or so. Maybe 20. So, moral of the story is, next stop was a mall. And this is a big fucking IndyCar 500 or IndyCar. It was like a big rally for autograph sessions, as a matter of fact. But it wasn't at Chicagoland Speedway. It was at a mall. So all the drivers are going to be there. All the drivers were there. I think I even got Milka Duno fucking. But anyways, when she seen me and the guys that I was with, fuck, she was like, are you guys like fucking following me around? Are you guys like stalking me? So that was pretty fucking funny. Got that close to her. She accused me of fucking stalking her. I feel fucking great. Like my life is successfully completed. Like to be accused from Danica Patrick of anything is like my long lost dream. I'm gonna go down in fucking my life's history and say, Danica Patrick accused me of fucking something in my life. I'm ready to die. Beat me to the fucking sharks. So, it was pretty fucking fun. I think this is it. Stay tuned, right? Here you guys go. Watch this shit.
Trigger, now he's dead. Mama, I'm huge on diversity and different kinds of people. You know, one of my big things is all God people, no matter what faith or level of faith you have, it's any. It's really not black, white, brown, yellow, crazy. So you guys all really good.
Thank you. Leading off for the Slammers, center fielder number 23, Travis Olin.
Thank you.
baseman number 8, Danny Zardone. First baseman number 39, Trenton Hill. What is going on down on the field, Zach?
Hey, I'm down here with Xavier and Jacob. And they're here for Advanced Urology's Race to the Bathroom.
All right, Zach, Jacob, go.
Come on.
Oh,
I gotta run.
You missed it, right?
Sorry, dude. Oh, I'm not even touching the bases.
Age before beauty.
Call me if you need something, man.
Thank you. Sebastiano Lamaze, France. Steel Point Racing with Vasco Sullivan imprint. And this will be heading for turn number four. We'll bring him home, Bob, and get the checkered flag.
All right, Sebastian Bourdais has completed his qualification run. And the speed on lap number four was 227.882, just a tick of the watch faster than the third lap. 39.494 seconds, 227.882 for lap four. The average speed is 228.090, and the third quickest so far. Now Danica Patrick will be next to go. And away she goes onto the racetrack. Danica Patrick, as we all know, retiring from racing, but wanted to do two more races, the Daytona 500 and the Indianapolis 500. And we're delighted and proud to have Danica back with us at the track this year. We wish her a lot of good luck as she completes her racing career here at the famed 2.5 mile oval.
This would be Danica's eighth Indianapolis 500. The last time she was here was 2011, November 25th and finished 10th. But she was up front. She led 10 laps in that race back in 05. She was the 500 rookie of the year, starting fourth and finished fourth, leading some 19 laps. And wherever she goes, Bob, everybody wants to go.
Completed for Danica Patrick, riding for Ed Carpenter Racing this year in her return to the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. Great onboard shot with Danica as she exits turn number two down the back stretch. Now setting up for turn number three. This will complete the two warm-up laps as Sebastian Bourdais gets congratulated by his team down below us. And Danica Patrick in turn number four, here she comes. And this will be the green flag for the beginning of her qualifying run. Here it is. The green flag is out for Danica Patrick.
One of the interesting notes about Danica, of many, I mentioned this is her eighth attempt for the 500. In seven races, she has completed all 200 laps some five different times. And that's not something you can say about a lot of drivers who don't manage to get all 200 laps in, but she takes care of the equipment really well. She's at the north end of the track, short chute, setting up for turn number four. Ready to come down the main straightaway and complete lap number one. Danica Patrick.
Warm-up lap was 222.684. This is lap number one completed. Good speed, 228.081 on lap number one. 39.468 seconds, 228.031. She is fifth fastest at the moment with one of the four laps completed.
If you're a race fan, you know she spent the last six seasons with Stuart Haas Racing over in NASCAR. And we're glad to have her back here at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. She has two top fives, six top tens, two races led for a total of 29 laps. Danica Patrick, here she comes again, Bob.
Two laps about to be completed. Two more. Is down to 227.597, 39.543 seconds, 227.589. That makes her fifth fastest so far.
Back straightaway, midway point of the back straightaway, and that number 13 machine for GoDaddy. Into turn number three, left hand turn, short chute, north end of the speedway. So far, so good. Average of 227.813, and Bob, she's going to take the flag now for lap number three.
Lap number three, it's just a little bit slower than the second lap, 227.545, 39.5527 seconds. So once again, a very consistent lap for Danica Patrick. Laps one, two, and three, very, very consistent.
Of course, the key to that speed right now, as you just mentioned, she's at number five on the speed chart. That puts her comfortably, at this point in time, in that top nine.
And if you're concerned right now about those top nine, on the bubble, so to speak, is Jay Howard with a 226.098. Here's the checkered flag. Qualified on a 227.269, lap number 4, 39.600 seconds. The average speed is 227.610, and that makes her fifth fastest of the 14 that we have qualified so far. All right, let's go down and have a conversation with James Hinchcliffe, who is in the field.
Down here with James Hinchcliffe, first one out after the weather. The conditions are a little bit different.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, the sun came out, which helped dry the track, but it also makes the track a lot hotter and greasier. But, you know, that's not it. We haven't been particularly quick all month, and we weren't expecting to be that slow. We weren't in the gear that we were expecting to run, so the car's not pulling very well. The engine's behave very differently when the temperature changes like that, and you know, without the opportunity to plug in and make sure everything was where it needed to be, it might hurt us. But
yeah, a lot of teams are struggling, and that's the drama that will be played out this afternoon as we get closer to 6 o'clock. Here's rookie Kyle Kaiser on the racetrack, another graduate of the Indy Light Series. Kyle Kaiser about to complete his first warm-up and his first qualification in a Verizon IndyCar Series race.
Kyle Kaiser out of Santa Clara, California, for Who Calls Racing. The juvenile, if you will.
Necessarily as good for the drivers, because as Sebastian told us and James Hinchcliffe told us, the track is getting warmed up and rather slippery, so that could be a factor as we progress here in the late afternoon.
Hilton, car 59 from Brigade, England, Bobbinson driving for Carlin. Last year started 15th and finished 4th. Had a terrific year. He led some 50 laps a year ago. This will be his third in the Indianapolis 500. And those numbers I gave you, 15th start, 4th finish, the best he has had in his career. In the Grand Prix a week or so ago, he started 16th and finished 16th on the road course here at the Speedway. Max Chilton for Carlin, car 59.
All right, here he comes for the great fly. Nice piece with him and his wife on television this morning. I saw they were watching, of course, the royal wedding and having some tea. So Max was able to find out how things went at the royal wedding before he turned his attention to going fast on the racetrack.
He's going fast right now at the north end of the speedway in the short chute. That's just turn number 4. We're going to find out pretty quickly how this lap is going. Here he comes toward the start finish line.
And one lap completed. The speed is 225.756. 25.756. 39.866 seconds. And the live rank shows you that right now he would slot into the 11th place.
A lot has been said, Bob, over the last, well, since the start of the IndyCar season about these new cars, how do they handle the traffic, this, that, and the other. It's been a learning experience for these engineers to get their teams and their cars ready for this qualifying.
Yeah, it's going to be a real question mark, too, on race day. And very optimistic as the drivers are, as well as they have the past few years with the new aero kit. 225.833, he's up just a little bit from the previous run. 39.852 seconds, 225.833, still ranked number 11 at the moment.
Halfway through this particular lap, going into the speedway, the temperature now has reached 104 degrees at that corner up there, so you have to be really careful. They come flying out of turn number 2 and up that back straightaway.
Now to turn number four and down the main straightaway.
All right, this is the white flag lap. Is 225.750, just about the same as lap number one. 39.867 seconds, 225.7. Ranked 11th at the moment with three laps completed, is averaging 225.780.
Line up in the middle of that fourth row right now, with a 225.780. See if I can pick things up here a little bit to get toward the north end of the track. And then we'll head it south down the main straightaway. Our starter's got the checkered flag out for the qualification run for Max Filton.
Here we go, checkered flag out. Flag number four is 225.327, his slowest. 39.941 seconds. The average speed is 225.666, and he is now 12. Let's talk to Danica.
We know she's happy to be here, and all you fans here today, I know you are happy as well. Let's talk a little bit first. This is your run. It was good. Everything was under control.
I felt good.
It was very consistent through the run. I didn't really have enough room to chase the car and try and keep freeing it up, but overall, it was very consistent as far as the way it felt. The time fell off a little bit, but I think it would have been nice to go out before the rain, but we didn't get that chance. So the good news is the sun's shining now, as far as no rain, but it makes it a little warmer. So hopefully the fans are enjoying the dry weather and qualifying. It's decent in the shade now, so I feel you because it's hot here on pit lane.
And she can hear you. Are you excited to see her here?
Again, I love Danica Patrick from the bottom of my heart. In 2005, when she started coming around over here at Chicagoland Speedway, was the actual year that I started going to Chicagoland Speedway. And it just so happened, by the time I got to Chicagoland Speedway, like that year in 2005, Indy cars were already done and hadn't really raced. So there was just no fucking way in hell that I was gonna see any kind of Indy cars. But the next year, because of NASCAR and what I saw of NASCAR, I was like, holy fuck, like I've never been to a fucking like a Chicagoland Speedway race. Now I waited because I got here in 2001 and got shown around in Joliet area and the racetrack, like this is a NASCAR race. I was like, or the racetrack, I was like, holy fuck. And I was like that fucking close. So every time the races before 2005 came down to town, and I could hear the fucking cars, I was getting like, oh shit, like I got nervous. Like I really wanted to hear these cars and see them. So, time went on. Finally got to the racetrack. As a matter of fact, I worked for a place called Barton Staffing. As a matter of fact, it was a temp agency in Joliet. So like, they asked me, hey, you know, are you busy? And I'm like, not really. They said, well, we need people over at the racetrack. It's a cleanup crew. Would you want to be a part of it and go up there and help clean up? And I'm like, well, hell yeah, fuck it. And they're like, well, they'll tell you what to do. Just show up. As a matter of fact, they told me, come down here now. It was like 10 o'clock in the afternoon. So they shipped us all the way down there. And the closer we got, I started getting really fucking nervous because those cars were fucking loud. Or what seemed loud then. Now they're not that loud, but it was loud. So I'm getting fucking nervous and shit, like freaking the fuck out. Like, oh shit. And this is NASCAR. So like they're going around and around. So they finally get us behind the grandstands, dude. And we're like behind the fucking grandstands. And three and four, like is at this end. Turn, of course, on the end of this grandstand's way is turn one and two. So you can choose sides or whatever, and walk around or whatever. You can sit at a seat, but sometimes they'll catch you with the ticket. Or they'll probably stop you from even going through. But anyways, so, you know, fucking So we're by turn four, right? Way in the very bottom, underneath, behind it, and these cars are like, meow, meow, meow. It's fucking loud as fuck, dude, and they're trying to talk to us, and they're telling us, wait until the race is done, and then we'll be ready to work, and there's like 60 laps left, and I'm like, holy fuck, and these cars are like, meow, 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 meow. I'm like, oh my fucking god, like, I just was hooked. I just thought it was like the coolest fucking thing. I've never been to a NASCAR or anything by that time at all in my life, and I was just like, holy fucking shit, like it just was just a whole new thing. And IndyCar is the whole moral of my story. I had yet to even fucking fall and play yet. This was until the following year. And that's when kind of Danica Patrick came around. Fucking Danica, where's my Danica shit at? What happened to my damn fucking card? Fucking Danica, that's when she started coming around. Super, super nice person, dude. I was just like, oh, I hooked, like, oh, fuck, and she was pretty as shit. Reminded me of an ex-girlfriend, believe it or not. Dated a girl just like that. And you know who you are. I won't say no names at all. So my friend is like, yeah, so she's up here signing fucking autographs. I think by that time it was like, I wasn't like really like, it was about maybe 2007-08 when I started hearing about Danica Patrick, started following or finding newspaper clippings of her, and fucking, so I kind of started keeping an eye out fucking what she was doing, whatever. She was doing really fucking good as a race car driver coming up, rookie and shit. Man, everything was all so fucking fine then, dude. She was ready to just fucking kick some ass, dude. When she got that first fucking win, I knew right away. She just keeps on with her fucking, you know, I didn't really see it coming when she decided to want to go to NASCAR. When I knew she decided to go to NASCAR, that was just, I knew it was already done and over with. Her passion to win and her passion to race, because them cars are a lot faster. You know, she went from driving fucking Miss Daisy to fucking driving fucking, we're talking fucking turtle fucking wax and shit, dude. All about the fucking money. Fucking, it was all about the fucking money. And I was just like, I mean, she looked so healthy back then, and you know what I mean? All tender and shit. I mean, she looked healthy, and everything was all fucking nice and featured and shit, you know what I'm saying? She looked really nice and so super, super, super nice and shit, dude. Now, I mean, I haven't seen her, long story why I didn't get to really see her, and why you guys only saw what you guys saw of footage, of any kind of fucking footage of my close encounter with Danica Patrick. It probably was meant that I probably would not have to gotten any closer than that, because who knows, I probably would end up in prison. Indianapolis prison. He probably would have had a fucking ball with me, dude. I definitely would have been Bubba's little bitch, dude. Definitely would have been Bubba's little bitch in Indianapolis. That would have been fucking scary as fuck. So, but anyways, fucking Danica Patrick, man, that was super, super fun, dude. I hope you guys enjoyed a little bit of footage that I got for you guys. Really, I had a long-ass story. I really don't want to go through what happened and shit, you know. I can say something?
Next episode.
Oh, yeah, next episode. Oh, so okay. So,
part two.
All right. So, as a matter of fact, no shit. I better read my notes here. Indianapolis 500 qualifying part one, May 19, 2018, right? Am I doing this right? 8 minutes in, 8 minutes out. So, Indianapolis, Indiana, like I was saying, you don't want to end up in no fucking prison over there. Qualifying, man, it was super, super fun. Those fucking cars fucking fast over there, man. 2 fucking mile long track. One side, no, two, I think it's like 2.5 miles. Anyways, one side alone. Fucking long ass stretch, dude. Like when I was in Chicagoland Speedway, the many, many years and many, many times I've been in Chicagoland, even Milwaukee, holy fuck it. Indianapolis, the fucking Brickyard. Oh my god, that's the dad of all fucking racetracks. That is the grandpa of fucking grandpa racetracks, dude. Old, ancient, history, and fucking huge. Hey, I said it. Danica Patrick, when Danica Patrick sold out and went to NASCAR, is about the same time when the Indy cars stopped going to Chicagoland Speedway, so I stopped seeing them running over here. There was just no fucking way I was going to see these cars run. So it had been years to get to that point right there of what you guys had just seen, right? Am I getting on track there? So it was fun, man. The thrill of Danica Patrick again, from the heart. I love you, Danica. I think this is okay. We're still going to see some more, so stay tuned next week, couple weeks.